Hello everyone, today we will discuss Entamoeba histolytica life cycle. Entamoeba histolytica life cycle. So previous class we will discuss stages of the Entamoeba histolytica: tropozoid stage, precystic stage, cystic stage. Today we will discuss life cycle of Entamoeba histolytica. Life cycle of Entamoeba histolytica. So first step, the life cycle of Entamoeba histolytica: tropozoid stage. Tropozoid stage. Tropozoid stage present in the mucosa and submucosa of a large intestine. Mucosa and submucosa of the large intestine. The Entamoeba histolytica is presenting in the, so the large intestine. The large intestine contain a layers. Just so they are the large intestine contain the transverse section. They are the three layers. So they are mucosa and submucosa. Mucosa and submucosa muscularis externa. So they are the layers of the large intestine. So they are living in the mucosa and submucosa of the large intestine. So the large intestine, they are presenting in the tropozoid stage. The tropozoid stage presenting in the large intestine, mucosa and submucosa layers. So these are the tropozoid stage. So they are presenting in the large intestine. So they are submucosa and mucosa of the large intestine. So these tropozoid stage, they multiple, they are the mitotic division. So the tropozoid stage is occurring in the mitotic division. The tropozoid stage. The tropozoid stage occurring the mitotic divisions, many mitotic divisions. Mitotic divisions means, so these are the one cell is divided into two cells. So the after another mitotic division, two cells is divided into four cells. After mitotic divisions, four cell is divided into eight cells. So they are the many mitotic divisions. So the tropozoid stage, they are many mitotic division. So they are increasing the number of the tropozoids, After the tropozoid stage, they eating to the food materials like bacteria. After mitotic divisions, after many mitotic divisions, the tropozoite eating bacteria, red blood cells, and tissue debris. So they are the eating to the tropozoid. The eating in the tropozoids, bacteria, red blood cells, the cell tissue debris, they eating to the tropozoid stage. So the size is increases. The tropozoid size is increased after mitotic divisions. After many mitotic divisions, So the simple, the mitotic is the main intention. So they are increasing the number of increasing the number of the tropozoites. So the tropozoite stage, there are many mitotic divisions, they are increasing of the number of the tropozoite stages. So these tropozoite stages eating to the bacteria and the red blood cells, so they are eating to the increasing the size. Next one, so the after the tropozoite stage, they are converting to the, so they are the binary fusion. So they are the binary fusion. So the after binary fusion, they transform to the precystic stage. So they transfer to the precystic stage. Precystic stage. So the tropozoite stage after binary fusion. So they are the repeated many binary fusions, mitotic divisions. So first one, second one, and third one. Third one, the formation of precystic stage. Next one, the precystic stage is converting to the cystic stage. So the precystic stage, they converting to the cystic stage. Cystic stage means the surrounding the membrane, surrounding the protecting membrane. So they are stage surrounding to the protecting membrane. So they are called as precystic stage. First of all, after many mitotic divisions, they converting to the tropozoite. Convert precystic stage. After precystic stage, they converting to the cystic stage. Once revised, so the tropozoite stage, many mitotic divisions. After many mitotic divisions, they eating to the cell debris, the increasing the size, they converting to the precystic stage. After precystic stage, they converting to the cystic stage. Fourth one, cystic stage means they are surrounding by the cyst wall, Next one, the cystic stage, the nucleus divided into two mitotic divisions. The nucleus, two mitotic divisions. So the two mitotic division, only nucleus division, only nucleus. Nucleus is divided into two mitotic divisions. One nucleus is divided into two nuclei. Next one, another mitotic division divided into four nuclei. They contain four nuclei. So they are called as tetracystic stage. So they are the fifth step. So the cystic stage, the nucleus, two mitotic divisions, divided into four nuclear stages. Four nuclear stages. So this stage is called as tetranucleate cystic stage. Tetranucleate cystic stage. So this entire process occurring the large intestine, walls of the large intestine. The entire process occurring the walls of the large intestine. So these are tetranucleate cystic stage. They enter into the lumen of the large intestine. They move to the outside through the fecal matter. The tetranucleate stage. The tetranucleate stage, they transform to the, they are moved to the outside through the fecal matter. Move to the outside through the fecal matter. Fecal matter. So this is through the outer through the fecal matter. So they are the large intestine. So in the large intestine, so they are presenting on the tetranucleate cystic stages. These tetranucleate cystic stages move to the outside through the fecal matter. So fecal matter, they're going to the outside. So the tetranucleate cystic stages move to the outside through the fecal matter. Tetranucleate. Tetranucleate cystic stage move to outside through the fecal matter. Fecal matter. So they are the sixth step. So they are the sixth step. The tetranucleate cystic stages are the move to the outside through the fecal matter. Through the fecal matter. So the tetranucleate cystic stages go to the outside through the fecal matter. So the this entire process, the tropozoid stage to tetranucleate cystic stage, this entire process complete few hours only. The entire process complete only few hours. They complete only few hours. The tropozoid stage to the tetranucleate cystic stage, this entire process is complete only few hours. Few hours. So the after tetranucleate cystic stage move to the outside through the fecal matter. Through the fecal matter. So these outside of the tetranucleate cystic stages, they are living in 10 days. The mast cell, they are living in 10 days. The outside the land, so the tetranucleate cystic stages, they are living in 10 days. After these tetranucleate cystic stages are the infective stages. Tetranucleate cystic stages are the infective stages. Infective stages. The tetranucleate cystic stage. The tetranucleate cystic stage is the infective stage. Through the, they are infection of the contaminated food and water. Contaminated food and water. Contaminated food and water. So they are entering from the new host. They are contaminated food and water. They are entering into the new host. Contaminated food and water. They entering to the new host. Entering to the new host. These are entering into the new host. So they are the entering from the new host. The first step. So they are the tetranucleate cystic stage. They are going to the outside through the fecal matter. So they are living in 10 days. In this 10 days period, so they are contaminated food and water. They are reaching to the another human host. Another human host. So they are reaching to the small intestine. They are reaching into the small intestine. Tetranucleate cystic stages, they are reaching into the small intestine. The tetranucleate cystic stages entering into the small intestine. The small intestine contain digestive enzymes. The small intestine contain digestive enzymes. Tetranucleate cystic stages reach human small intestine. Human small intestine. Tetranucleate cystic stages, they are reaching to the human small intestine. Human small intestine. they are reaching into the human small intestine. Human small intestine. So this cystic, the cyst wall, is dissolving. The cyst wall dissolving action of the enzymes, action of the digestive enzymes. Our small intestine contain many digestive enzymes. So these digestive enzymes dissolving the cyst wall, So they are releasing from the tetranucleate cystic stage. They are releasing tetranucleate cystic stage. So they are the 8th step, releasing tetranucleate cystic stage. They are occurring from the small intestine, After these tetranucleate cystic stage, one mitotic division. So they are divided into So they are divided into 8 daughter nuclei. So one mitotic division, they are divided into 8 daughter nuclei. So these 8 daughter nuclei, they surround the few cytoplasm. They are separating the 8 tropozoids. These 8 tetranucleates, 8 stages of the tropozoid stage, they are divided into 8 tropozoids. So they are divided into 8 tropozoids. So they are the metacystic stage. So they are called as metacystic stages. These are the 10th one. So they are the 9th one. So these stages are called metacystic stage. So these are metacystic stages. They are transformed to the single one. So these are the metacystic stages. These transfer to the single. Each one is transferred to the tropozoid stage. So they are the life cycle of the entamoeba histolytica. Once revised. So they are the presenting in the tropozoid stages, presenting in the large intestine. So they are the many mitotic divisions. So increasing of the number of the tropozoid stage. After they transform to the precystic stage. After the precystic stage, they converting to the cystic stage. Cystic stage, the nucleus is divided into 2 mitotic division. They divide into 4 daughter nuclei. So this stage is called as tetranucleate cystic stage. So this tetranucleate cystic stage going to the outside through the fecal matter. So there, this entire process is complete in only few hours. These tetranucleate cystic stages outer side, they are living in 10 days. So they are reaching to the contaminated food and water. They entering to the another human host. So they are reaching to the small intestine. In the small intestine, they contain digestive enzymes. Small intestine contain digestive enzymes. So these digestive enzymes rupturing of the cyst wall, So the releasing of the tetranucleate cystic stage. So the tetranucleate cystic stage, 2 mitotic divisions. So that one mitotic division, so divided into 8 daughter nuclei. So they are called as metacystic stage. So the each daughter nuclei, they separate one tropozoid. So they are the life cycle of entamoeba histolytica. Next one, extra intestinal migration. So the extra intestinal migration means these are tropozoid stage. They entering into the liver. So lungs to liver, heart, kidney, brain, gonads. So extra intestinal migration. So they are migration outside the intestine. So the first, the tropozoid stage, they reaching to the lungs, reaching to the liver, reaching to the heart, reaching to the brain, reaching to the kidneys. reaching to the gonads. So they are causing to the amoebic disease. So they are the causing to the amoebic dysentery disease. Amoebic dysentery disease. So they are the life cycle of Entamoeba histolytica. Next one, pathogenicity. Entamoeba histolytica pathogenicity. So these Entamoeba histolytica trophozoite stage. They are releasing to the hormone enzyme. They are releasing to the Entamoeba histolytica releasing the enzyme. So they are the histolysin. Entamoeba histolyting release one enzyme histolysin. Histolysin. So these histolysin. The Entamoeba histolytica releasing histoline. So these histolysin, so they are the dissolving, so they are the disappear, so dissolving of the infection of the large intestine. Just example, just rough diagram. So these are the large intestine. So this trophozoite stage, these Entamoeba histolytica releasing to the enzyme histolysin. So these enzyme histolysin, so they are eating to the walls of the large intestine. Walls of the large intestine. So the large intestine causes the ulcers. These enzyme. So they are the action of the enzyme. So they are the dissolving of the walls of the large intestine. Dissolving the walls of the large intestine. So they are releasing from the blood and mucus. Releasing to the blood and mucus. So the fecal matter, they coming the fecal matter outside. They coming blood and mucus. The fecal matter coming outside through the blood and mucus. So this disease is called as amoebic dysentery disease. This disease is called a amoebic dysentery disease or amoebiasis disease. So the Entamoeba histolytica causing to the human beings, they causing the disease amoebic dysentery. Amoebic dysentery means, so these Entamoeba histolytica, so they are the infection of the large intestine, walls of the large intestine. So they are releasing to the blood and mucus from the mucus fecal matter. So they are the amoebic dysentery. Some human beings, there is no causing to the infections. There is no causing the infection. But so these human beings are the carrier. So they are transferred from the one person to another person. So many human beings, they causing to the amoebic dysentery disease. Some persons are the do not affecting the amoebiasis. So these are the, they are carrying. So they are the increasing the number of the trophozoites. So that persons are carrying to the carrying persons. So they are carrying the Entamoeba histolytica. So they are the amoebic dysentery disease. They causing to the Entamoeba histolytica. Next one, prophylaxis. Prophylaxis. So prophylaxis means, first of all, so there while drinking boiled water. So the after before the drinking water, the water is heating after the drinking. So the drinking boiled water. Next one, hand wash and vegetables and fruits for washing before the eating. So the hands, fruits or vegetables are the washing. Next one, they using proper septic tank toilets. Septic tank toilets. So they are the prophylaxis. So they are the prevention of this disease. Majorly they are purified water, means boiled drinking water. The next one, so the hands are the washing, fruits are the washing, and the vegetables are the before the eating washing. Next one, they using only toilets, the septic tank toilets. So the fecal matter going to the outside. So they are infection transfer from the one person to another person. So they are using the toilets, septic tank toilets. So they are the do not spreading the amoebic dysentery disease. The do not spreading the Entamoeba histolytica. So they are the life cycle of Entamoeba histolytica. Simple ट्रोपोजाइट स्टेज, मेनी माइटाटिक डिविजन्स, प्रीसिस्टिक स्टेज, सिस्टिक स्टेज, टेट्रा न्यूक्लियर सिस्टिक स्टेज, दे आर मूव टू द आउटसाइड, रीचिंग टू द न्यू होस्ट, कंटामिनेटेड फूड एंड वाटर, द रीचिंग टू द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन कंटेन डाइजेस्टिव एंजाइम्स, द सिस्ट वॉल इज रप्चर, दे रीचिंग टू द फोर टेट्रा न्यूक्लियर सिस्टिक स्टेज. सो द वन माइटाटिक डिविजन दे कम एंड फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एट डॉटर न्यूक्लियर. सो द एट डॉटर न्यूक्लियर दे सेपरेट द एट ट्रोपोजाइट स्टेजेस. सो दे आर द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ एंटमीबा हिस्टोलाइटिका.